We did last year, but the enthusiasm that we have here this time has upped the ante. Just all there is to it. And I've got some fabulous players, and most of you recognize them, but hang on to your ears. It's going to be more than a pleasure. It's going to be a bit of heaven. And that's what we hope to achieve. Before we get started, one of our, quote, main players at this particular venue was Mike Caldwell. And God decided, no, I want him up on my Saturday morning lineup. Because God always has the best. And I just want to do this. I want to take a few moments of just silence and you think about where Mike is and how happy we are that that is where he is. Because it is not sad, it is a celebration. And I guarantee you, if you could hear, you know he'd be playing more notes than all of us put together up here. So that's just the way that works. And so just kind of get inside, in your heart, in your mind, and it's optimistic is what I'm trying to tell you. Let's take that few moments. Thank you. And we praise you with everything, Lord. Thank you. First one I'm going to do is open the ball here. It's called All That Thrills My Soul Is Jesus. I don't need anything else. I mean, that's just where it is. And if I focus on that, whatever else is going in my life, I'm good with it because he's in charge. I'm not. Here it goes.
Thank you.
Thank you. Buddy Greene.
Very nice, Phil. So good to be up here with all these good players and friends. Well, as usual, I come to these meetings about half-cocked. Not much of an idea of what to do, but that's all right. I got good backup support. Yes?
Use this microphone right here if that's easier.
Oh, this is...
Set it down right here and you guys can pass it.
Oh, okay. Great.
Just talk into the microphone.
Okay. Great. Thanks. Last year we were in Tulsa, and Joe was with us. Joe Filisko just came without Eric, just he and his harmonicas. He showed up, and he was a one-man force of nature like he always is. And he did an old gospel tune called 12 Gates to the City, which is one of my favorites. It's been done by everybody, Reverend Gary Davis, Sonny and Brownie, Rosetta Tharpe, you know, everybody has done some version of this. But all the versions I'd ever heard of this song, you know, it comes from the 12 Gates to the City image, you know, comes from the last two chapters in the Bible, in Revelation, where John the Revelator, he gets this vision, you know, of the new Jerusalem coming down. And then he gets this big, huge vision of the new heavens and the new earth. You know, the 12 gates are open. They never close. All the nations are flowing in. It's just nothing but peace and harmony. All the tears and all the sadness, all the disease, all the stuff, bad stuff is gone. And it's God's new creation, and it's what we've all been waiting for, you know. And I was thinking, man, we need to write some of that into this song, you know. So being a shameless songwriter, I took this public domain song and had my way with it. So now it's got a chorus, and it invites participation. So, you know, just jump on in. I'll sing the chorus for you so you'll know it. It requires just a little short-term memory, no overhead help. Right. Oh, what a beautiful city. Oh, what a beautiful city. God knows it's a beautiful city. 12 gates to the city. Hallelujah. Amen. Try it with me. Well, oh, what a beautiful city. Oh, what a beautiful city now. Oh, what a beautiful city. 12 gates to the city. Hallelujah. Amen. Well, I saw the new Jerusalem city, along and deep as it was wide, coming down out of heaven, beautiful and holy, prepared to be God's bride. Well, there's no more crying in the city, and no more death or pain. Well, everything's made new, is the gospel truth, and all the old things have passed away. Can you help me now? Oh, what a beautiful city. Oh, and what a beautiful city. God knows it's a beautiful city. 12 gates to the city. Hallelujah. Amen. I didn't see a temple in the city. I saw God and the Lamb instead. I saw the glory of God giving light, and the Lamb was a lamp, like the Revelator said. Well, every tribe, nation, and tongue, well, they were walking together as one. And all the kings of the earth were bringing their worth into the city that needs no sun. Can you help me now? Oh, what a beautiful city. Oh, what a beautiful city. God knows it's a beautiful city. 12 gates to the city. Hallelujah. Amen. Todd Parrott, I bet you could play, while I got this guitar in my hand, I bet you could play something nice on your A harp. Yeah. what you call showing up ready for the gig right there. Well, now the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. You know the Lion and the Lamb, the great I Am. He's got a message for every kind of man. And he says, if you're thirsty, come to the city. Come drink from the water of life. You know there is no cost. Don't stay lost. Come inherit your eternal life. But can you help me now? Oh, what a beautiful city. Oh, and what a beautiful city. God knows it's a beautiful city. 12 gates to the city. Hallelujah. Amen. Yeah. Oh, I'm gonna play my harp, but I gotta find a way to get in there. Noden, now that you're in there, I want you to play, would you? That's it. Oh, well, there were three gates in the east, three gates in the north, three gates in the south, gates in the west, whoa, and that makes 12 gates to the city. Hallelujah, amen. Can you help me now? Oh, what a beautiful city. Oh, and what a beautiful city. God knows it's a beautiful city. 12 gates to the city. Hallelujah, amen. I say there were 12 gates to the city. Hallelujah, amen. Well, there were 12 gates to the city, yeah. Hallelujah, amen.
Hello. Check, check, check. All right. I brought along a helper as well. I'd like to put your hands together for my lovely assistant one time for the busiest guy here at SPAH, Mr. Danny Rupa. Yeah, all right. Lie with sighs in hell, sit down. With sighs in heaven, sitting down. Oh, angel, oh, my Lord. I wish I in heaven, sitting down. Take away my sin and give me grace. Take away my sin and give me grace. Oh, angel, oh, my Lord, I wish I was in heaven sitting down. Hey, play that guitar for me, would you, Dan? Well, I ain't gonna be tired no more, no more. Ain't gonna be tired no more. Oh, angel, oh my Lord, I wish I was in heaven sitting down. I'd be putting on that long white robe, putting on that long white robe. Oh, angel, oh, my Lord, I wish I was in heaven sitting down. Be sitting at my Jesus' feet. I can't wait. Sitting at my Jesus' feet. Oh, angel, oh, my Lord. I wish I was in heaven sitting down. Feel free to help if you want. I wish I was in heaven sitting down. Yeah. Wish I was in heaven sitting down. Oh, angel, oh, my Lord, I wish I was in heaven sitting down. Tag it one time. Oh, angel, oh, my Lord, I wish I was in heaven sitting down. Thank you. That was a Reverend Robert Wilkins song. I should have said that at the beginning. Thank you so much.
Last day. All right, testing. Good, good, good.
Let me hear the guitar.
Can you bring the guitar down a little bit in the monitors, please? Thank you.
Yeah, do it now. From that tag thing, you know. Yeah. Thank you.
Jesus sees his child clean and free of hate. My Jesus sees his child clean and free of hate. Men are cruel, men will fall, but mercy's great and grace is free. If anyone should not throw stones, it's me. Thank you very much.
Thanks again for having me on this show, Phil Duncan. This is always a highlight of SPAH. Good to be here with all these great players. And this next little tune, depending on what part of the country you live in, you could sing it, "There is power, power." But if you're down south, "There is power, power, wonder working power." So this is "Power in the Blood" or "Power in the Blood." All right. Maybe just a little more track, just a little bit. Sing it.
Thanks, Todd. Now Joe knows why I had him go before Todd.
Who made that sentence?
I figure, well, why not? He plays that banana harmonica, and it's just nondescript because I can't figure it out. So, but anyway, Todd, that was just great. And I do mind following you. But I'm going to take it down about 3,000 notches at what I call below normal speed and attempt. There is a fountain filled with blood. I think we're ready.
Years ago, I recorded an album. It was kind of a retrospective. I'd made up my mind. I was tired of recording albums and selling 12 copies a year. I thought, I think I'm done with this. So I started thinking about I like my last album to sound like. And I thought about all this this wonderful life I'd been able to live, and by the grace of God, and to realize so many dreams, and then just to look back over it and see God's hand in it all along. And there was a long period from like my adolescence till I was nearly 30 years old, where I was really lost in the world, lost in my own delusions and everything else. But you know, I was learning music, and I was going through the school of hard knocks, and making a lot of mistakes and all. But all along the way, I was just getting these signs that God was nearby. He was haunting me. And one of the ways I knew it is I'd be singing some song like Amazing Grace, or I'd be in a bar and somebody'd strike up a gospel tune, and I'd think, man, that kind of sets something loose in my heart, you know. and they'd come from some of the most unlikely places. I was a big Sonny and Brownie fan, and learning harmonica and just loving what Sonny did, and also being a guitar player, I love what Brownie did. And they did an album. It was a very unusual album for Sonny and Brownie because it was real produced. It was on a major label. There were people like John Mayall and Arlo Guthrie and Leon Russell. All these people were, you know, a part of the experience. And a lot of people think this was sort of an overproduced Sonny and Brownie thing, but I kind of think it's wonderful because I listened to it so much, and there were so many cool songs on there. Brownie singing People Get Ready and stuff like that. It was just really cool. And there was a song on there that I listened to, and it was, boy, it just hit me right where I was. So when I started putting this album together a few years ago, I remembered it and thought, I wonder if I could come up with a version of that. I showed this to Dan yesterday. So Dan, if you can, it's easy.
What
jump
key is it?
At E. Send E. Yeah.
Edward.
Yeah.
Why, sure, buddy.
Hey, that's all right. It'll go around several times. You can let it go by and see. It's about four or five chords, and that's it. Took my body to the doctor. Said, man, you won't live through the night. But I took my body home to mama. She said, Jesus gonna make it all right. She said, Jesus gonna make it all right. Carried my head down to the drugstore, but I fell and I missed my flight. I carried my head back home to mama. She said, Jesus gonna make it all right. She said, Jesus gonna make it all right. Thank you. myself as a hunter. Yeah, lying on the loose in the night. But I took all my weapons home to mama. She said, Jesus gonna make it all right. She said, Jesus gonna make it all right. She said, Jesus gonna make it all right. Oh, my Jesus gonna make it all right.
I want to say something about this next player. He is new to the stage, but in Kindred, he's just with us. There's no doubt about it. And Charlie, I'm sure happy that you're here. I mean, you know, he talked to me about 5 years ago, and of course that was before the pandemic, and he says, you know, I'd like to play on that. And I went, yeah, right, okay, no problem. And I didn't know who he was. And I thought, well, I don't know how many of you know who he is, but I actually met him at one of the gospel community deals that was here, and after all the stuff is over, you go to the gospel thing and play, and that kind of told me something about him, but I really didn't know about him until actually I met him this year. I called him on the phone, and we had a great conversation. I met him here, and you talk about a kindred brother. If you haven't met Charlie, you're missing something in this life. Seek him out. Tell him you appreciate him. You know, not that he needs it, but you need it. Get it? It's not about him. It's about you. And he will bless you. He did me. I didn't have to ask him for that blessing. It just happened when I met him here this round. It was just wonderful. And Charlie, I appreciate your spirit. That's the way we talk up here, in case you don't know that. And we're trying to give that over to you, and then you give it back to us. Charlie, it's all yours. Charlie Barath.
Man, thank you so much, Phil. And I agree with everything you said.
Better. I'm taking nothing back.
No, I appreciate you having me here. It's truly a blessing to be here on the stage with these incredible men. And Joe Filisko.
Ooh, no politics. Ooh. It's going to take you the rest of your life to get forgiven.
Now, I'm going to do one straight out of the hymnal. I'm going to give Danny a break on this one. I hope y'all like it.
Thank you. Phil, thank you for saying that about Charlie. You were spot on. I think you might have missed a few things, though. Charlie is one of my favorite living harmonica players, and I have the advantage I've known Charlie a very long time. I've probably known him longer than most. I wrote a review of his fairly recent record and gushed. His versatility is amazing. It's very amazing. So you best be ready, because I might call you out to do a solo on this song here in F. Could I get a little bit more of the voice and the monitors, please? Testing one. Hey, hey, hey. A little more. Oh, yeah.
There you are.
Yeah. In order to not accidentally do a song that somebody else was planning to do, Mr. Noden and I have been doing original songs. So if you like any of the stuff we're doing, and you want to help out us poor musicians that sell a dozen CDs a year.
Sell. Make it 13, 14.
You can sell these things? Thank you.
Fantastic, fantastic. This is a song that I've been playing recently. I've always loved this song. It's, in my opinion, one of the best gospel songs ever written by a guy named Andre Crouch. And you may or may not know it, but the words just say, "How can I say thanks for the things that you've done for me? Things so undeserved, but you proved that you gave to prove your love for me. The voices of a million angels could not express my gratitude. All that I have and ever hope to be, I owe it all to thee." And in the chorus, you may know, "To God be the glory, to God be the glory." So I'm going to do "To God be the glory," also known as "My Tribute." And if you know it and you want to sing it, please do. It feels good. All right?
Thank you.
Everybody, please stand up. I know you've been sitting there. I don't want to get any kind of stuff in your legs and then go to your heart. And we have to pray you out of that. And we could do it this morning. I'm going to tell you that right now. You're safe in God's hands in here. At least I feel it. So shake it around a little bit. And when you feel comfortable, go ahead and sit back down. And then we're going to do the final part of this show.
Put your right foot out and then your left foot in.
Hokey pokey. Very good. Wow. If I can find this next one and know what I'm doing, I'll be fine. Let's see here. Ah, here it is. I don't have to look at it. It's just a crutch. If it's sitting there, then I can make it through it. Yeah, this is going to be standing on the promises. I've done this in the past, and I haven't done it for some time. And it's a little up-tempo. It's full orchestration of it. And it took me a long time to work my way through this. You know, it's one of those things, too many instruments and too many notes. But it's one of those things that Todd inspired me to chase down and see if I could do it and not tell him I was doing that because he'd end up doing it himself, and then I would quit playing. So it's one of those things. I don't share everything. Anyway, standing on the promises. Thank you. Thank you.
Bill Nelson, you got it, man.
Buddy Greene.
Mighty fine, Phil. Good stuff, man. I got to follow that. How many of you were in the gospel jam last night? Any of you come by? Yeah, we had a good room in there last night. It was a lot of fun, and it was a big old mess. But it was not a hot mess. It was a cool mess. And it reminds me of an old pastor friend I used to have. He loved to remind us that the gospel is not about keeping a bunch of rules or trying to be good for God or deserve your place at the table or any of that. He says, no, he liked to quote like the Apostle Paul, who said, if I'm going to boast in anything, I'm going to boast in my weakness, because in my weakness, his strength is made perfect. He said, that's the heart of the gospel. And so he liked that. And then after he'd preached a sermon like that, he'd say, now go out there and make a mess. And I always love that, because, I mean, that's about all I can do is make a mess. So we're going to make a mess now. None of this is rehearsed, and you just show up at these things, and you if you think about it too hard, you make a mess, but it might be a hot mess. It won't be a cool mess. So I'm going to do this old song. I first heard it by a bluegrass group, but I found out it goes back at least as far as the great Sam Cooke, when he was a gospel singer, singing with a group called the Soul Stirrers. And it was called Jesus Gave Me Water, based on that great story of Jesus with the woman at the well. So so you're going to be a part of this mess, all right? So this has got to... When the Soul Stirrers did this, Sam Cooke would sing the lead. He'd say, oh, Jesus, he gave me water. Jesus gave me water. Jesus, he gave me water. I won't let his praises swell. Jesus, he gave me water. Jesus gave me that water. Jesus gave me water, and it was not in the well. Now, that is not your part. Your part is... right behind me. Now, you're just going to be this cool backup section now. Oh, Jesus, he gave me water. 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 Ooh. He gave me water. 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 He gave me water, and it was not in the well. Now, this is hard for a room full of white people. Because I got you working on the beat that you're not familiar with, all right? That's all right. Through your weakness, his strength is made perfect. All right? Oh, Jesus, he gave me water. He gave me water. Jesus, he gave me water. I won't let his praises swell. Jesus, he gave me water. Jesus gave me that water. Jesus gave me water, and it was not in the well. Not bad. It's a mess, though. All right, and I kind of showed this very quickly to Eric. So, Eric, jump in there and help me if you can. Dan, you're on your own. And then you other guys with the harmonicas, get ready, because we may need some extra solos. All right, all right. It's a key of E. Oh, Jesus, he gave me water. Jesus gave me water. Jesus, he gave me water. I won't let his praises swell. Jesus, he gave me water. Gave me that love and lasting water. Water, and it was not in the well. Well, there was a woman from Samaria. I came to the well to get some water. And there she met a stranger who did her story tell. Well, that woman dropped her pitcher. She drank and was made richer from the water he gave her. And it was not in the well. Well, Jesus, he gave me water. Jesus gave me water. Jesus, he gave me water. swell. Jesus, he gave me water, gave me that love in lasting water, water, and it was not in the well. Oh, play one, Charlie, while you're up there. Dropped her pitcher. Let's see, I'm doing this wrong. Let me start this verse over. Right. Well, when that woman he had pity, she ran back to the city, crying glory, hallelujah, and did his wonders tell. She ran back to the city. She came back to him bringing all the water he gave her, and it was not in the well. Well, Jesus, he gave her water. Jesus gave her water. Oh, Jesus, he gave her water. I won't let his praises swell. Jesus, he gave her water. He gave her that everlasting water. Water, and it was not in the well. Joe Filisko. Shouting, there was no room for doubting that she had met her Savior, who did her wonders tell. Every time she doubted him, well, she stopped to think about him. Oh, the one who gave her that water, and it was not in the well. Well, Jesus, he gave her water. Jesus gave her water. Jesus, he gave her water. I won't let his praises swell. Jesus, he gave her water. Well, he gave her that love and lasting water. Water, and it was not in. Well, Jesus, he gave her water. Well, he gave her that love and lasting water. One. Now watch me now. Oh, one. Well, he gave her that water. Sing it now. Gave her that water. Said he gave her that water. Gave her that water. Oh, gave her water. Didn't come from the well. Oh, gave her that water. It wasn't living water. Loving water. Oh, it was lapped in water. Oh, it didn't come from the well. It was living in water. Keep it up now. Oh, everybody play. Come on now. Come on, Todd, Parrott. Lasting water, it was a loving water. Well, he gave her that living, loving, lasting water, and it was not in the well. That was a cool mess.
How about that? Just like we rehearsed it.
Just like it. Just like choir practice.
Once again, I want to thank Phil for inviting me to do this. I've only been pestering him for 5 or 6 years. but, you know, squeaky wheel and all that. And I thank Danny for helping me out on this song and the first song. And again, thank you for making this such a fantastic event, and personally for making me feel welcome here. So, thank you.
Good to have you, Charlie.
This is one you might know. Don't hold back when you feel moved. How about a nice G chord, Danny? I shall not be moved. I shall not be moved like a tree planted by the water. I shall not be moved.
One, two, three, and.
I shall not be moved. I shall not be moved like a tree planted by the water. I shall not be moved. Jesus is my Savior. I shall not be moved. I'm in His loving favor. I shall not be moved like a tree planted by the water. I shall not be in my Christ abiding, I shall not be moved. In His love I'm hiding, I shall not be moved like a tree planted by water. I shall not be moved. If I trust Him ever, I shall not be moved. He will leave me never. I shall not be moved, oh, like a tree planted by the water. I shall not be moved. Rock of ages, I shall not be moved. Man, I love that rock of ages. I shall not be moved like a tree planted by the water. I shall not be moved. Come on, y'all. I shall not be moved. I shall not be moved, oh, like a tree planted by the water. I shall not be moved. Now all the voices. I shall not be moved. I shall not be moved like a tree planted by the water. I shall not be moved.
It was cool, yeah. That accordion thing, what was that? Chanka? Chanka. All right, chanka. Yeah. So, we're going to redo a little tune we did the other night that I'm going to try as hard as I can to make it sound like an accordion. Why do you ask? Why do you want to do that? Because I can. And it sounds good. It sounds good. Yeah, that's right. We're going to do it for our dear friend, Mr. Jerry DeVilliers, who I spoke to on the phone yesterday evening, and he's good, but it probably was wise for him not to push things and try to come. But it was so close. We had everything, all the little pieces in place, but we just didn't quite pull it off. So there will be another harmonic event that Jerry will be teaching at in South Louisiana, Lafayette, blown away on the bayou in the end of October. So thank you for reminding me about that. It's good to know. Yes, you still have a chance to study with Mr. Jerry at the end of October. Here's my best chanka.
if you're singing, he will hear you. If you're singing, he will hear you. If you're singing, he will hear you. When you sing to the Lord, and if you're dancing, he will see you. If you're dancing, he will see you. And if you're dancing, he will see you. When you dance for the Lord.
How does he do that?
Hey, I'm just happy I don't have to follow you, man. Oh. Thank you, Phil.
Yeah, my daughter, I have a daughter and a son now. Praise God for that. Two wonderful children. Her favorite harmonica player right now is Peter Mad Cat Ruth because of Rollin' Tumblin'. And she likes that, but her favorite harmonica song is Stay Out of My Kitchen by Joe Filisko. So we'll be driving, she'll say, Daddy, turn on the kitchen song. So not a gospel song, but anyway. But I'm thankful for my two babies. So this is a good song to do. It's just says, glory to his name. So I've got a heart of thanks and thanksgiving and praise today. So glory to his name. All right. I'm sorry, I think that's the one with vocal in it. There may be one. There should be one without with the vocal in the track. I'm sorry about that. I think there were two of them on that stick. And if the other one has vocal, we'll do something else. We've got other stuff back there. But you appreciate these sound guys. It's a lot to keep up with this week. Thank you guys. We'll try it again here and see here in a moment.
That's the only one we have.
Is that it?
Yeah.
That's all right. I tell you what, just run Amazing Grace back there. Do you have that? Let's do that. There we go, that'll work.
Mm-hmm.
Let's sing it.
Amen. How sweet that
Todd Parrott. Well, I want to thank you for being here. We enjoy the Lord up here. I don't know what you did down there because I'm not down there with you. But I feel that you have and have gotten something at the end of this session, this week. It's been a wonderful week. And it's just been glorious. I don't think I could have put more perfect vendors in the vendor room. They are just so gracious to everyone. And, then in turn, you're being gracious to them. I've heard that what they're telling me this morning. So that's really good. Appreciate that. We are a family. I don't know if you feel it, but I feel it. Yeah. Charlie taught me that when he met me on Tuesday or Wednesday, and I went, wow, he's family. He's my brother. I didn't realize that. Wow, pretty cool. And these others, of course, my brothers anyway. They don't have no choice. You know, they are sons of my God. Hello. And I don't have any daughters up here, but we have daughters out there. I don't want to exclude that by any means. But I want to thank these people specifically for sharing their heart. Their harmonica I expected, but they shared their heart. And that is what moves me. Todd tries to steal our thunder, and he made it look like it just didn't work out, so he had to do his song that he and I fight over almost every time since he started recording that, Amazing Grace, because it's so amazing, it's hard for me to say no, and it wouldn't make any difference, he'll do it anyway. He will find a way. He's learned, you know, from the Lord, he'll just find a way. And if you don't love Todd, you don't know Todd. Let me put it that way. So it's amazing what he can get away with when you love somebody. I mean, it's simple as that. So we're gonna do the Amazing Grace. It's not something that's a surprise to y'all. You know, this is our closing number, and we need to do that, and I need to quit talking because Joe has official date somewhere in this building called teach-in. And that's an important entity in this spa. This is important, but what he does is important as well. We want to lift this. We want to get it out in the community and be as good as we can be. Thank you, Joe. We appreciate you. Okay, we're going to start this. It'll play through at once. I did that before because I made sure everybody knew the tune. And but I think we kind of got that nailed. So we're going to start it. But I'm going to let it run through its segment with the piano. I was hoping to have Harris Simon here, but something came up physically and he couldn't make it, and then he would just do it on the piano, and I always let him go one around with it, and then I play, and then we go on down the line. That's what we're going to do, and then when we finish all the way down to Joe, then all of us are going to play, and then we're just going to pick whatever note we want to, and then the last time, we're going to try to see if we can find that melody. Okay, we're ready for that. Gentlemen, stand up. It'll be at you before you know it. So you may start the. I don't think there's any voices on this.
Thank you.
improvise. Thank you very much. Appreciate you. Y'all have a good Saturday and a safe trip home.
Thank you, Phil.
That's great, brother.
I tell you, if I planned this, it wouldn't be as good. It wouldn't be any good at all.